how do you craft a way forward for the pound, or do you just, it's not possible at the moment, such is the range of outcomes here?
No, it's entirely possible. It is possible. At the moment, I sense a bid tone to the pound, and that is because of a delay in uncertainty. Anything that delays uncertainty on a currency when the market is positioned short will be good for that currency. We currently have three political developments, all of which indicate a delay. We have a delay on the Brexit front, we have a delay on the election front, potentially, and we have indeed a delay on Parliament itself. So we've got a three-pronged delay on uncertainty. So there's a temporary bid for the pound. What I sense is volatility will come off for cable and sterling crosses. That will generate bids, put bids back into the sterling itself. And that will temporarily support the pound. So I see some upside in sterling in the short term based on delay. But we remember in March, of course, this year, the first time we got a delay on Brexit, the support for the pound rallying was just a temporary phenomenon. So I sense that will be the case this time round. So we'll probably maintain a reasonably firm pound as we run into October, as we run into the Queen kicking off on the new Parliament. Upside on sterling, lower vol.
And of course, we've got the conference season just coming up before we hear from the Queen and opening the new Parliament, haven't we, Neil? Which often produces some headlines that could move things around a little bit, I suppose. Where do you see? So that's the short term then, and this is all around delay. But that, you know, delay is not a destination in itself, as many people point out when it comes to Brexit. Where do you see this heading then, with a sort of longer term horizon? Mm.
Well, I see turmoil kicking off again in October, mid-late October. There are just a whole host of moving political parts, domestically speaking, which will reignite that whole kind of uncertainty, which is likely to weigh on a currency. Nothing disturbs a currency more than uncertainty, and we are destined to see it again. So beyond October 15, especially if there will be much turmoil over over elections, Parliament returning, it will all boot off again, and I think that will send the pound down as the turmoil, uncertainty will take pound lower again.
If no deal looks less likely, but Jeremy Corbyn looks closer to number 10, where does that leave the pound, Neil?
Well, for me, what really takes the pound lower or higher, as I say, is not knowing the political outcome. Once you've got certainty from an election, which is likely to be in November, it's almost regardless of kind of who wins, if there's a majority or if there's a coalition. Once that is established, once the political uncertainty is out of the way, it could be an opposition coalition, it could be a majority in Parliament, a host of unknown variables. But once it's done, once investors around the world know where we are with regards to Brexit, know where we are with regards to election, it will be the largest sell rumour, buy on fact mentality. I do think money will flood back into the UK regardless of who wins the election. I'm actually convinced of it.